Hello students, today we will start the fifth lesson, legislation as a means to reduce air pollution. So now, how the law helps in reducing the air pollution? Usually the laws set the standards for safe emission and also impose penalties on the people, and it may ban on industries if the industries violate the law. Air Act. So this act maintains the air quality by setting the ambient air quality standards and ensuring that the pollution levels will be reduced by using proper devices. There are two agencies in India, the Central Pollution Control Board CPCB and the State Pollution Control Board, which are used, which are meant for controlling pollution. So what are the main objectives of these agencies? To find out the existing source of pollution and the nature of emission. To find the existing source of pollution and the nature of emission. Lay out the standards of emission for different industries. Lay out the standards of emissions for different industries. Advise the government on air pollution control policies in relation to industries, production, energy conservation, transportation, waste disposal and planning. Administer the permit system for state sources that contribute to air pollution. It not only helps or advise the government, but also it administer the permit system for state sources also. State governments also to control the air pollution. Set up the laboratories to act as a national center for testing analytical and sampling techniques. So what are the steps taken by the Delhi government to reduce air pollution? So Delhi is the most polluted city in India. So the Delhi government has taken some measures to reduce the air pollution. So first one, pollution control by transport system. Pollution control by transport department or transport system. Public awareness campaign to educate the motorist and the non-motorist about the health hazards and control measures. Fixing of catalytic converters to reduce the pollution levels. Non-commercial vehicles must comply Bharat Stage 2 or Euro 2 emission norms. So, non-commercial vehicles, they should comply Bharat Stage 2 or Euro 2 emission norms. Now, improvement of fuel quality by introducing unleaded petrol and low sulfur diesel. Because to increase the efficiency of the vehicle, they made unleaded petrol, but that will cause us more damage. So, by improving the fuel quality, by introducing unleaded petrol and low quality diesel. Phasing out of old commercial vehicles to reduce air pollution. The vehicles which are used more than 15 years, that should be phased out because that will cause us more pollution. So that is very, very important, especially to phase out the commercial vehicles which have served more than 15 years. And it is mandatory to use CNG for all the vehicles. So what are the features of Air Act? So Air Act in India, it has been introduced in 1981 for the prevention and control of air pollution. So what are the features of this Air Act? It helps in prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. It helps in prevention, control, and abatement of air pollution. Maintaining air quality. Authorizing the central and state board to prevent and control the air pollution. And these boards can prohibit the use of any vehicle which causing more pollution. The authorized person must check the samples of air from any chimneys or any industries. So penalty for violation or default under this air act. So if any vehicle or anything is violating the law, or industries are violating the law, so they can impose penalty for this violation. Taj Mahal trapezium. So nowadays this is a big issue in India, as the Taj is turning yellow because of the pollution. So that pollution is mainly due to the oil refineries near Taj Mahal, that is Mathura oil refineries. So this releases more content of sulfur, and this sulfur forms acid rain due to the formation of acid rain. So that actually Taj Mahal is made up of marble that is reacts with acid rain, acids that are formed. So that because of the reaction, it is turning yellow. So what is Taj trapezium? So our Taj trapezium, it is the an area of 10,400 square kilometer around the Taj Mahal. So Taj Mahal, it is one of the wonders of the world, but due to acid rain, so now it is polluted. So to protect from the pollution, and they have introduced or they have started Taj trapezium zone. This Taj Mahal trapezium zone is an area of 10,400 square kilometer around the Taj Mahal to protect the this monument from the pollution. So what are the measures or steps taken to reduce air pollution? So mainly it has banned the use of coal in the industries. It has banned the use of coal industries, that industries are located near the TTZ. The short form is TTZ. Sometimes they may ask expand TTZ. So Taj trapezium zone. So first step is they have banned the usage of coal in the industries which are located near the TTZ, and also they advised that industries to use natural gas over coal or coke. So creating the green belt around the TTZ, creating the green belt around the TTZ by plantation program, and also they have planted more than 1,000 tulsi saplings around the Taj Mahal, because tulsi, it is a good absorber of these pollutants. And parking is kept at a safer distance, nearly 25 meters away from the Taj Mahal. And the vehicles which will move near the Taj Mahal, they are battery operated vehicles. And they have they used aluminium silicate paste or multani mitti, we can say. So they will make a paste of this aluminium silicate paste or multani mitti, and they will coat completely the Taj nearly yearly or sometime at least 3 years once, because that will remove the pollutants also from that Taj Mahal. And monitoring system is placed near the Taj Mahal to check the pollution levels in that area. And the visitors are given special cloths or shoes to move around the Taj. So these are the measures taken by the TTZ to prevent the pollution. Now the alternative fuel, that is CNG or compressed natural gas. So the CNG is a mixture of hydrocarbons with 80% methane in the gaseous form. It is colorless, non-carcinogenic, and non-toxic. So main thing is it is colorless, non-toxic, and non-carcinogenic. It is inflammable and is lighter than air. it is inflammable and lighter than air. But it, when you compare to the fossil fuels like petrol, it is superior in quality, and operational cost is one third of that petrol. For petrol, how much we are using, it is reduced, and it is called as a green fuel, as the emissions from this, it is a very low emissions, and even it allows the catalytic converters to work more efficiently than diesel. What are the advantages of CNG? Definitely it is environmental friendly or eco friendly, as it does not release any greenhouse gases. They have low maintenance cost and than regular fuels what we are using, petrol and diesel. So it is cheaper than petrol and diesel. It increases the life of the lubricants, lubricating oil. It increases the life of the lubricating oil, and as it does not dilute the oil, and it makes the engine cleaner and efficient. Now let us discuss about the disadvantages of CNG. So it is not available in all the places. It is not available in the in all the places, and the engines, the vehicles needs more modification. It needs more storage space than conventional petrol cars, as to keep the batteries, cylinders, not batteries, it is cylinders. So the, there are more chances of accidents due to the leakage of the cylinder, and it may catch fire. So these CNG vehicles do not give good speed. By this we come to the end of the first part of legislation as a means to reduce air pollution.